I'm going to show the steps I use to create a SQLite database in C# using Entity Framework Core. I'll create a simple database that stores airports and countries. I'm using Visual Studio 22.NET 8.0, and the first step is to add a SQLite data provider in Nuget Manager. I'm installing Microsoft.EntityFrameworkCore.SQLite. Now that it's installed, step two is to create or update classes to map the DB structure. This is the country class. Since it has an ID field, EF Core will assign that as the primary key when creating the table. I didn't add a default value for it because it would try to insert that value for new records. In the airport class, EF Core can't determine the primary key, so I identify it using data annotations above the property. I also use a navigation property so I can include the country when reading airports. Step 3 is to create an extended DbContext class to handle transactions. A DB set is added for airports and countries. Override onConfiguring to set the SQLite connection string. Also override onModelCreating. Here I'm adding a constraint to restrict countries from being deleted if referenced in the airport table. You can add a foreign key using data annotations, but the delete behavior can't be changed there. Here I see the countries table with data when a new database is created. Step 4 is to tell the DbContext to create the database during startup. I'll run the app. And it created the database on the desktop. I view the database in Windows command line using SQLite 3. It created both tables. And it seeded the countries table. To run transactions against the database, I use DbContext methods. Insert uses DbContext.add. For this insert, I'm showing how to capture a new ID from another table. Update uses find and update. Delete uses find and remove. To query the database, I copy the DB set to a list and return it. That include is how I pull the country object with airport. I've updated the form startup to insert a few records and display them in a list view. I'll run it. And it shows the four inserts. So that's it. Those are the steps I use. I'll add a link to the CS files in the description.